Yeah, no, you ain't no psycho. You're not like the others, no. No changing behaviors. Not sure how to act around you. So colorful and bright, yeah. I wanna be a 9 to 5.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am here with my beautiful model, Mame.
Hi.
We are here in Manhattan Beach testing out the difference between the 5D Mark IV and the Canon R5. I've got the same lens on each one. It's the 24-70 2.8L version 2. And on here I have the adapter so I could actually use this EF lens on my RF camera. And yeah, we're just gonna be testing out the difference to see what works best in what light. Before we get into this video, just know I have linked the beautiful Mame in the description below, so make sure you check out her page. And make sure you like, subscribe, and hit the little bell button so you don't miss a future upload. Gonna fall down. This ain't my final ride. So for the first look, we're gonna start backlit in order to capture the light before it gets a little too harsh. I'm gonna start with my R5 and then I'll go through and take the same photos with my 5D Mark IV so that we can compare the two. So Mame, if you wanna turn your body a little bit this way, not too much, yeah, that's perfect. And then your face goes a little that way too, but your eyes are at me. Beautiful. Maybe the back hand's up in your hair. Gorgeous. Chin down so the light's not too harsh, yeah. So we're starting here. I'm having her turn her body a little bit more towards the ocean, away from the sun, so the light isn't too harsh. And we're backlighting it. That's beautiful, Mame. Oh, love. And I'm just making sure to get different angles to really showcase her body and her curves. Gorgeous. Chin down for me. Yeah, the light's a little harsh, so as long as her chin's down, it works really well. And I'm shooting in an f5, 1/1000th of a second, and an ISO 200. Body a little more away from the sun. Yeah, gorgeous. I wanna get to know you. I don't wanna leave so soon. You and me forever. Or maybe just for tonight. Do you wanna get to know me? I will give it all to you. I'm changing my settings to reflect the same settings that are on my R5. Beautiful. Wow, this feels so different. The sound of the shutter, it feels like a dinosaur. I use back button focus on this, whereas the R5 has the auto IAF, so I don't have to keep refocusing, which is really nice on the R5. One of my favorite features about the R5 is the built-in eye autofocus tracking system. What this does is it locks the focus onto the model's eyes and it follows them around. So this is great for movement shots and any kind of motion. If the model's running directly at the camera, it will keep the image in focus based on where the model's eyes are. So because my model has darker skin, when the highlights are really intense, there's a different contrast involved. Chin down. Yeah, so we have to keep her chin down so that we don't have those harsh highlights on her face, so it doesn't get blown out. So now we're gonna shoot in harsh light to show you guys how each camera performs in the harsh light. I'm gonna start with the R5 again and I'll show you how it goes. So now we're shooting her in the harsh light here by the water. That's so beautiful. I love the highlight on her chest. Yes, gorgeous. Shooting from a lower angle to make sure my shadow's not in it. Beautiful. It's doing really great on this R5. The focus is super sharp, on point.
One of the things I noticed about the R5 is that the sound of the shutter is really quiet. When you're shooting in a place like the beach or anywhere outside with a lot of background noise, this can be an issue as the model sometimes uses the sound of the shutter as a cue to move on to the next pose. But as long as you're communicating with your model and you're letting her know to keep moving freely or to get into a different pose whenever you're ready, you can still capture all of the same images regardless of the sound of the shutter.
So I'm changing my settings again to reflect the same settings. I'm at 1/3200th of a second because we're in brighter sunlight, ISO 200 and F5. And we're gonna start with the same pose just to show you guys exactly the same shot with a different camera. So one thing I'm noticing about this camera is that when I look in the viewfinder, The colors are very different because it's not OLED. So I'm just seeing bright sunlight. I'm not seeing what the actual image looks like in regards to the, or as opposed to the R5, where everything kind of looks how it's going to look on the actual photo. Beautiful. Love. Cool. This hair, like, kind of, yeah, better. So it's definitely a different feel shooting with this camera. This one kind of feels like a dinosaur. It's a bit heavier. Viewfinder is much different. This one's the OLED viewfinder on the R5, and this is just like what you see is what you get straight through. It doesn't show the different settings and how they reflect in the camera. So definitely a different feel. I find that I compose the images a bit differently with each camera. Maybe it has to do with the weight, but really enjoy seeing the difference. I can't wait to share the final results with you guys. So now we're going to shoot her in the shade with the both cameras, and I'm going to show you guys the difference and how each camera performs in this lighting situation. So for these, I'm a little bit closer to the water, so I'm using my back screen, which is a lot easier to use on the R5. I'm using that so that I don't have to get low because I'm holding two cameras. I don't want the cameras to get wet, so it just really comes in handy here. Beautiful. Love. Oh yeah, this is beautiful. For the sake of the video, I'm going to shoot with the screen here so that I can tell you guys the difference. It feels a bit more laggy on the 5D Mark IV. Everything lags a bit. It takes a second to go through. As soon as I press the button, I just feel it kind of hesitate. Gorgeous. Beautiful, Mame. I find myself composing much differently with both cameras, which is really interesting. I think it has to do with the weight. I noticed it on the last look and I'm noticing it here. Really interesting. I'm excited to compare the two side by side and see how they look. So now I'm going to take B-roll backlit on each camera so that you can see how the video quality looks from the R5 to the 5D Mark IV.
So taking a look at these videos, you can tell that the footage from the Mark IV is a little bit shakier than the footage from the R5. The R5 actually has 8 stops of image stabilization built into the camera, which helps when shooting handheld. Whether it be for photo or video, you definitely get a clearer image or a less shaky video as a result of this. And that caught me off guard when I looked at the video in post and realized that my white balance was completely off. So remember when using the R5 that the photo and video settings are different and you'll need to adjust them accordingly when you switch between the two. Overall, I think both the Mark IV and the R5 are absolutely great cameras. I do really love the built-in eye autofocus, and that alone is a reason for me to use the R5 over the Mark IV. And I also love that it's 45 megapixels because I can crop in these images and get a completely different image. I can crop in on her face and get a beauty image that I might not have thought to get before, just because the resolution is so nice. So I do love my R5. However, if you've got the Mark IV and it still works great for you, I don't think it's a necessary upgrade. But if your Mark IV is going bad and it's older and you're looking to upgrade anyways, I think the R5 is a great option.
Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know in the comment section down below what you think, which camera you want to try out, which one you like better. And make sure you check out Mame. I've linked her down in the description below. Like, subscribe, bell button, all the things. Peace out.
Follow us on Instagram. Oh, would you call me on my sins?
I need